Johnny, it's Bobby Sloan!
Hey, Graves! Your mate Larry having a party tonight, is he?
Maybe.
Plenty of birds, plenty of booze, is that right, is it?
Maybe.
See you there!
Maybe. It should be good tonight, though, eh? Plenty of birds, plenty of booze. Yeah, what time does it start?
Don't know.
Better ask Larry.
But where is Larry?
You winked at me.
And me? He winked at me and all?
Shirley, that was definitely a one-girl wink.
Terrific motor, innit?
Yeah. Lot of money, though.
Who cares about the money? Huh? Gonna make it easier to pull the birds.
Is it?
Well, of course it is. Got a fast motor. Birds think you're a fast fella. Got a flash motor. Birds think you're a flash fella. As it happens, this motor's both very fast and very flash.
They think you're a fast flash fella.
Yeah! Stupid, innit?
Yeah, stupid.
Can I borrow it?
Nah.
Good morning, Mrs. Henderson. Mrs. Ascot, lovely to see you. Mr. Ascot?
Larry.
Wonderful sermon, Vicar. So true. So clear. Oh, my God, that's disgusting. New Year's Eve. Don't you think so, Vicar?
Oh, yes. All that racing about and making a racket.
Good fun, though, I'll bet.
Oh, yes. All that racing about and making a racket.
What a pity the youth club had to be closed down. All that table tennis and lemonade. Oh, it was a wonderful club.
Oh, yeah, wonderful.
Wonderful kids from wonderful families.
I do happen to know that it was the families, the parents, that clubbed together and bought me this wonderful watch.
It's only money.
Our money.
The credit really belongs to Larry's friend, Johnny Reeves. He went from house to house, telling people of all the good work you'd been doing in the club and how, in his opinion, you deserved a little thank you present.
Wonderful fellow.
I was happy to contribute.
That's so much.
Yeah.
Too much. I know for a fact this watch cost £50.
You mean £250?
The parents parents contributed £250, Vicar.
No. Johnny drove me to the shop himself.
Drove you? In what?
His new car.
Since when could Johnny Reeves afford a new car?
Since he started making collections for the Vicar.
About this watch. You're welcome, Vicar. Very welcome.
Terrific motor, innit, eh?
Yeah. Lot of money, though, innit, John? £200.
Who cares about the money? Gonna make it easier for us to pull the birds.
You never pull the birds.
Well, I will now. I mean, when the birds see me driving about in a fast flash motor, they're going to think I'm a fast flash fella.
Yeah, but you ain't driving, are you? You're the passenger.
All right. They're going to think I'm a fast flash passenger. Stupid, isn't it?
Yeah, stupid. Can I sit up front with you?
No.
He's got a Bronson-like chest.
Who?
Charles Bronson, the film fella. If we're lucky, he'll have the Bronson bum to match.
Will he?
If we're lucky. My God, his chest. His chest is bigger than Bronson's.
Is that good?
Is that good? Don't be silly, Shirley. If he's got a bigger chest than Bronson, imagine what his bum's going to be like. Big? Bloody beautiful.
Here, girls. You fancy a party tonight, eh? Don't do that to my car.
Good air, isn't it?
Yeah, nice.
Just hanging about, spying on people.
Yeah, I wonder if he's taken his pants off yet.
Hope so. I mean, if I'm going to invite him to Larry's party tonight,
you want to make sure it's worth your while.
Larry having a party tonight, is he?
Yeah. What are you doing creeping up on us like that for?
I'm a policeman, aren't I? I'm here. I'm there. I'm everywhere.
Inspecting parts of the community?
Well, you ain't inspecting my part of the community.
Not here, anyway. Do you want to come to the party tonight?
Maybe.
Got that one, 7-8. It's a right bollock, this is. Am I meant to get to your party without a motor?
You live down the road, you don't need a motor.
That'd be so daft, Larry. Of course you need a motor. If you're going to pull the birds, you've got to have a motor. Ain't that right, John?
Here's your teas, boys.
Thanks, Mum.
Oh, and Johnny, don't forget to change your overalls before you come inside the house.
Yes, ma'am.
Here, John.
Here, I see that Jenny Dixie the other night.
Who?
Oh, fat bird, really ugly.
Oh, I know, hideous.
That's the one. You went out of her, didn't you?
No, I never.
Yes, you did. She gave you the push.
She never gave me the push. Just that our star signs happened to clash. We was mentally incompatible. So she said.
That's right, she'd give you the push.
She never give me the push!
Ah! Oh!
sorry, Rebecca. Did I hurt you?
Certainly not.
Can I ask you a question, Rebecca?
Yes!
Honest answer?
Yes!
In your opinion, what is the role of today's woman in today's police force?
I would have thought that was obvious.
Is it?
A woman can give the same protection to the public as a man.
Can she? What I mean is, has a woman got the physical presence, the physical ability to deter an attack?
With training.
Well, you've had your training. You've had 2 years of training.
So?
So, could you deter an attack?
Maybe.
Knife attack?
Probably.
Gun attack? How about a sex attack? Oh! Oh! Oh!
Definitely.
Oh. Oh, well, that's all right then. I just wanted to know.
Come on, Brenda. We've got to get down the calf before it closes.
Well, I don't like the calf. I don't like the calf. Nobody likes the calf. That's where the blokes go.
I've got to get myself lined up for tonight. I want to have a good time. I'm determined to see the new year in with a bang. Exactly.
All right, Tel. Hello, darling. What would you say if I asked you out tonight?
Eh?
Eh?
You just asked me out.
No. I was just seeing what this looks like from a bird's point of view.
Oh. And how does it look?
Fantastic.
Sam, you're a man of the world.
Well, I like to think so, Tel.
You give us a piece of advice, Sam. I've been going out with this bird for 3 years.
Yeah.
And I love her. I need her. She left me. I mean, what can I do? It's cracking me up.
Well, there's two things you can do, Tel. You can get so depressed...
I am depressed.
You can get so depressed that she feels sorry for you, comes back to you, or you get off with her best mate.
Oh, I hate her best mate.
Well, that's not the point, is it? I mean...
You're all right, Sam?
Eh?
You're not hurt?
Of course I'm not hurt.
Or upset?
Or upset? Why should I be upset?
You're upset, Sam?
No, I just said I weren't upset.
That's all right, then.
Rebecca... Constable, you did very well.
I know. Treat 'em mean, keep 'em keen.
You ain't half a bastard sometimes.
I know.
Keep 'em keen? She fancies you.
Oh, no.
Ain't bad. Get him to take you. Yeah. Nice legs. But he ain't built. He ain't got the shoulders. And that bloke just went to the toilet. He had the shoulders. Well, get him to take you then. But he ain't got the legs.
Oh. Here, let up.
What?
Towards the ball.
Eh?
That's me, towards the ball, you know, my star sign. Oh. You are all exciting. Nothing here about me and Jenny Dix being incompatible.
Yeah, what about tonight? What about the party? Well, let's have a look.
They shouldn't be allowed to print this sort of thing in a paper.
You in for a good time, then?
Fantastic. Come on.
You can't be choosy, Shirley. I mean, you ain't...
I ain't what?
It's all right for you. You got someone. You got that copper, Diggins. I ain't got no one. You'll find someone.
What about him?
That Toby.
Yeah, anyway, that Brenda's looking at me. She coming to the party tonight?
Yeah. Go and chat her up. Well, he's all right. He's idiot. And short.
No. I ain't wearing me aftershave. The thing is, I never pulled a bird without wearing me aftershave.
You never pulled a bird.
Well, give a bloke a chance, he just bought the bloody aftershave.
There's a notice on the board regarding New Year's Eve parties.
Sarge.
I don't want them interfered with.
What?
I don't want the fun spoiled.
But that's our job. I mean, we can't have drunks all over the place and getting away with it.
Orders from above, so don't argue.
Does that mean we get the night off?
If you want it.
I want it. What any coppers about? Plenty of parties. I could get paralytic.
You what?
In a sensible sort of way, Sarge.
I want it.
So do I. And there's a party I've been invited to. You fancy it?
Are we going?
In a minute, Frank. How you feeling now, Larry?
Worse.
We could stay in.
We will not.
For heaven's sake, Frank, your son's ill.
Nah, it's all right, Mum. You go out and enjoy yourself.
Well, if you're sure.
Yeah, I'll just stay in and watch a bit of telly. Go to bed.
I'll get it. Do stay put.
Oi, your mate Tommy Dorgan.
What about him?
His mother going to this New Year's thing tonight, is she?
Aye.
The vicarage dance, Mrs. Dorgan. Is she going?
Well, how should I know? I'm ill. Besides, I don't know Mrs. Dorgan. I know her son, Tommy.
Evening, Mrs. Escott. Party not started yet.
What party?
Hey! Wally! Happy New Year!
Hey! Am I the first? Oh, I got you a present, Larry.
Thanks.
Larry is ill.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, very ill, if you know what I mean.
Oh. Well, no party then.
No, there never was one, was there, eh, Tom?
Weren't there?
No!
You seen my coat, Frank?
What coat?
Oh, for Christ's sake, we'll never.
It's a bit unexpected.
Eh?
What is the illness of yours?
Yeah, and catching.
Are you a mate of Tommy Dawkins?
Toby don't know Mrs. Dawkins, Dad.
Dad's not asking about Mrs. Dawkins, he's asking about Tommy Dawkins.
Frank, you see my purse?
No! Actually, it was Mrs. Dawkins I was interested in.
Eh?
Oh, I don't mean...
Yeah, I know what you mean, Dad. Mum! I've seen your purse in the bathroom.
She wears all them tight trousers, don't she? Eh?
Who?
Mrs. Dawkins. All curvy and swervy. Eh? You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
Yeah,
we all know exactly what you mean.
What are you lot laughing at?
Nothing.
By the time I get back, I want to find you safely tucked up in bed. Come on.
Hey, good luck.
It's a shame it's off.
What?
All the party?
It ain't off, it's on.
Is it?
Well, what do you think all that winking was about?
Oh, I thought it was part of your illness.
You prat. What are you laughing at?
I'm going to pull tonight.
You reckon?
Well, don't I always, eh?
No.
Well, I will tonight.
Johnny Reeves is going to give me some tips.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Tips on how to pull the birds. Me, eh?
But you never pull the birds.
Well, I will tonight.
What?
Yeah. Don't you laugh.
Look.
If I'm going to pull a bird, I'm going to pull a bird, and that's a fact. I hope.
If I don't get a bloke tonight, I'll kill myself.
You should be wearing a low-cut dress.
I don't want the blokes to think I'm easy.
You are easy.
I know that. You know that. I just don't want them to know it. Not yet, anyway.
Okay.
No, thanks. Gonna stay alert, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, now listen. Just because you got the night off, right, I don't want you getting out of hand.
Oh, no, no.
No, right.
My aftershave. Good, innit? Wild stallion.
Smells like horses.
No, it doesn't! Does it? No.
You think that Roger Smith will be there tonight?
How should I know?
I wonder who will be there.
You know?
Larry's mates, I suppose.
I'm not that Toby.
Bound to be. I met him in a pub the other night.
they work in a stable or something?
I don't think so.
Smells like it.
Nick, I just want to get on party! God, blimey, I could do with getting my hands on some of that.
You ain't getting your hands on nothing till we get in the party.
Come on, Rebecca! We ain't got all night.
Shirley fancies you.
Yeah, no, Shirley fancies anyone.
She fancies you and all.
I fancy Brenda.
Everyone fancies Brenda.
Yeah, but I've got an advantage. I mean, with my natural good looks and Johnny Reeves' tips, I'm about to end up pulling her, eh?
You're not forgetting the aftershave.
I'll never forget my aftershave. And after tonight, nor will she. Hello, Shell.
All right.
Yeah. Hello, Brenda.
Hello.
Here we go. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Larry. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Brenda.
Rat.
But Brenda.
Toby.
Johnny.
No.
Oh.
Blazers, ate all your razors while pulling the waiters, talking about Monroe, walking on Snow White. New York's a go-go and everything tastes nice. Poor little greenie.
Dickens likes me, Larry. Of course he likes you.
Yeah, you're a good-looking girl.
We're both good-lookers.
You want to bet? As I was saying, you're a good-looking girl. So I don't see why not.
And why is he chatting up Rebecca Perry?
Drink?
Martini.
And you'll stay here? You won't go?
Dry martini.
Shaken, not stirred.
Should I know you?
Reeves. Johnny Reeves. Gene,
Come on. Come on, enjoy yourself.
When I'm ready.
To the party. Well,
that's all right. It's lovely to see you. Loads of people here, you know. Do you want a drink?
Terrific.
In the kitchen.
All right.
What'd you bring him for?
It's my fiance. We're engaged. Like my ring.
Sod the ring?
What do you mean sod the ring? That's a diamond, that is. £250 worth of diamond.
I don't care how much of a diamond it is. You were supposed to be with me. That was the reason for your invitation. Half the bleeding reason for the party was that you were supposed to be upstairs in a bedroom with me.
He asked me to marry him.
And you accepted?
Of course I accepted. £250 worth of diamond, you don't say no, do you?
No, you don't, do you? Couldn't say no to anyone, ever.
That was in the past. I'm respectable now. Gonna get married.
Good. Well, now that you're gonna get married, you can start having a few last-minute flings.
Wouldn't be fair on Tony.
So, Tony, you were supposed to be with me.
Well, here's to the day Sharon said yes. Because a while back, when I was down on my bended knees, I thought she was going to say no.
Yeah, you shouldn't have worried about that. She never says no.
I'll drink to that.
So will I.
Hold up. You follow her in, yeah? Don't say nothing, eh? First, see, that's the way they like it. You got to play them along for a moment or two. Then, you light a fag. Slowly turning your head towards her. Your eyes meet. Inhale on the fag. Smile. Then let the cool smoke waft slowly from your gob. Then you give her your best line.
Oh, I ain't got one. Well, you give us one and I'll give it to her.
No, no, my lines wouldn't suit you. You've got to have your own personal pulling line.
I thought you were supposed to be chatting me up.
I'm chatting you up. I've made myself known to you. Give us a chance and I'll get back to you. Just at the moment, I haven't got the time.
I have.
Push off.
You all right, Rebecca? These people bothering you?
No, no. People like this don't bother me. Out of uniform, Samuel. What's the word?
Less authoritative.
Terribly attractive.
You think so?
No. Don't want him to think that I think so.
Hey?
Your arms! So big! I like strong men.
I could blow this!
No. When your eyes are fixed on one another and the mood takes you, you'll think of something. Whatever you do, don't blow that.
inside the ring.
Ready, steady, go. Ready, steady, go. I'm not in love with television. I'm not in love with the radio. I'm not in love with the keystroke. Because I'm in love with Kathy McGowan.
Larry, listen, I better tell you. Bobby Sloan's coming down tonight.
Oh, you're joking. What, with his mates?
I don't know.
Listen, then, do us a favour, will you? Stand on the door and give us a shout when he gets here.
Oh, look, I'm here to enjoy the party.
Oh, you won't be able to enjoy it if Bobby gets here, will you?
Damn right. You all right?
Oh, Larry, it's a wonderful listen, party.
Try not to be sick, eh?
Yeah, Johnny, I need a tissue.
Sod off.
I need help.
Later.
Oh, please.
Sod off!
Chad, you have done well for yourself. I like to think so. I mean, who would have thought it? Who would have thought that you, of all people, was going to get married?
No, it can't be.
What?
Haven't I seen...
I mean, a year ago you was a spotty little fat girl with a lisp.
I was never a son of all the people to get. To get Tony.
Yeah. I get Tony, your old boyfriend. Yeah, my old boyfriend.
A week or so back, I'm so in the pages, and I see you. On the front of my mum's underwear catalogue. You see, my cousin, he's in the business. See, you want his phone number?
Hey. You trying to chat up my fiancé?
No, not me, no. My cousin, he's in underwear, the business. You see what I mean?
You ain't lost none of your aggression, have you, Tony?
Nope.
I like a man with aggression.
You're not too much, eh? I mean, it's never a good idea to be too aggressive.
Push off.
William! William!
Oh. Here, Tony. You remember little Ben Simpson?
Who?
Ben Simpson. You was pals.
Was we?
Yeah, of course you was. But don't worry. I'll look after Sharon. You and then have a couple of drinks and a chat, eh?
Okay.
Well, enjoy yourself. Got a plan to help you out.
Hey?
Help you get your last minute fling before you get married.
What any love?
Of course you do. Now, listen.
Yeah. It's Ralph, isn't it? Toby, remember?
Who?
Push off, will ya? I got me hands full.
Yeah, I can see that.
We was at school together, me and him. We was mates.
No, and you like me.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Here, Ralph. Can you smell horses?
I'll see you around.
Yeah, I hope not.
Creep!
Cheers.
You alright, mate?
Too much to drink, eh? Yeah. God, that bad, is it? Yeah. Yeah. Stick your fingers down your throat. Look. Stick your finger... fingers down your throat. Stop. It's going to go on. Go on. Go on. Cheers, mate. Oh, cheers.
Don't mention it.
Come in, my baby.
Who?
Sharon?
Who?
Pratt. Yeah, yeah.
Ooh. Yeah, what you doing all alone in the pottage head reading the dirty book, eh?
Waiting.
Yeah, I thought so.
Waiting.
Oh, who for?
Never you mind, eh?
Yeah, why didn't you show us this before, eh?
It ain't mine, it's me dad's, and don't you tell my mum.
Well, don't look at the writing, look at the pictures.
I wanna read.
I wanna look.
Look, it's my bloody book.
It ain't yours, it's your dad's.
And don't you tell my mum. A mysterious macho image, easily obtained, using few accessories. Layered hair, digital watch.
Soul boy belt, lame socks.
How do you know that?
Well, my dad reads their magazines and all, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And don't you tell my mum.
I ain't got no lame socks,
Tob. You ain't got no lame socks, Leo. You ain't got nothing.
Larry?
Hey?
Larry. Tony's in the toilet, so just 5 minutes, all right? Just one last 5 minute fling. Larry?
No.
Tony?
No.
You won't tell Tony?
About what?
About Larry.
Huh?
I mean, I'd do anything.
Anything?
Anything. Like I say, Tony's in the toilet. I've got me 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
Before I get married.
Oh.
I do want a fling.
Oh.
A last fling.
Yeah.
You must understand that.
Yeah.
God, you're tall.
Yeah.
Oh, it's you!
Well, give us a kiss then. I thought you was desperate.
Not that desperate.
Hey. What's the game, girl?
Hello, Tone. It weren't me. It was him.
Huh?
He tried to kiss me.
Oh.
You tried to kiss my bird?
Your fiancé.
You tried to kiss my fiancé?
You trying to kiss his fiancé?
Bastard.
Creep! Cheers for that, mate.
Yeah. Cheers, Leo.
Hot, isn't it?
Yeah.
I thought you liked strong men.
I do.
Well, he ain't strong.
I never said I was.
Then why is she dancing with you?
Look, Sam, it's a party. People are meant to enjoy themselves.
Yeah, they have fun. They dance.
Oh, yeah? Well, no one's dancing with me.
Why don't you ask someone?
All right, I'll ask someone. Dance?
No, thanks.
No.
Want a drink?
Yes, please.
You're everywhere and nowhere, babe.
I don't like dancing.
You might if you found the right partner.
Oh, yeah? You see anyone I might like?
Oh, what about me?
Yeah. What about you?
Oh, for Christ's sake, dance, you bastard.
But what if the tip don't work?
It will.
But what if it don't?
If it don't, I'll give you another one.
Well, couldn't you give us a few now to be going on with?
No. Look, stop sodding about and get in there.
Johnny, Johnny.
What?
Where are you going to be?
Bedroom.
Who with?
I don't know. I haven't chosen yet.
Johnny.
Hello, Shirley.
Listen, Johnny, I was wondering...
Keep wondering, Shirley.
There you are. I told you I was the right partner. You enjoyed that, didn't you?
No.
A good party, innit, eh?
So?
Yeah, it is good.
Plenty of room to dance?
Yeah.
Plenty to drink?
Yeah.
And plenty of good-looking girls like yourself?
Yeah.
And plenty of good-looking fellas, eh?
Where? No one's even talking to me. You should have worn a low-cut dress. Tell you what we could do.
What?
And I'll guarantee success. Where are we going?
Upstairs.
Bottle of beer, bottle of beer. Top off.
Top off.
Top on.
Top on.
Now when a girl sees that, she thinks...
You'll know what she thinks.
Right.
Cheers, John.
Bobby Sloan's coming up the path!
Quite simple, then. You just gotta say no to these people.
I'm sorry, Bobby. No.
Yes.
That's fair enough, isn't it?
Hold still! Not too low, eh? Just low enough to attract.
You know, in all my experience of police training, Rebecca, you're doing remarkably well. However, I do think for the sake of the training, we ought to start spending a bit more time together.
Yeah? Yeah.
Pictures tomorrow night, for example, on for a meal afterwards.
Hello, Rebecca, all right?
You know this man, Rebecca?
She nicked me last week.
You were fighting in the street?
Yeah. Yeah, see my ear?
Yeah?
Plastic.
Eh?
Well, you was there. Three of them, rival gang, remember? They held me down and they cut it off.
Yeah?
Yeah, with an hatchet.
No.
Yeah. Can't you see the joint?
No. No, it looks all right to me.
Pardon?
I don't think it's a good idea to discuss police matters while off duty.
No, who's to know, eh? Look, besides, she ain't like a normal copper is. She's nice.
Come on.
Hey, just this once.
Hey, who's to know?
Wouldn't be fair on Sharon. Remember, you're engaged to Sharon. You asked Sharon to marry you. You didn't ask me.
I was out of work. I was bored. And I wanted something to liven up my life.
Won't get that from marriage, will you?
Well, I thought I would. It's something different, some excitement.
If you wanted excitement, you should have come to me. Just you remember the exciting times we had in the back of my dad's old car.
Yeah. Was he fixed the suspension yet?
Oi, Tony!
Yes?
Tony, come here!
Congratulations.
Top off, top on.
Top off, top on. Top off.
You're talking dirty.
Eh?
Top off, top on.
No. Go in.
Aye?
Tooth.
Cracked.
Well?
What?
Well, what about a last minute thing? Somewhere secret?
They're French.
Oh, I knew that. I've smoked these before. That's where I got this nose, in France. That's why it's like this. This shape. Fighting in France.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, jump on me, Og.
You what?
Me bike. Before you know it, I'm in France, fighting. Professionally, for a living, right?
Do you know him?
Well, obviously he knows me. Everyone knows me. We used to work together before he got the job down a supermarket.
I thought you were a boxer in France. Professional. For a living.
What prick told you that, eh?
I did, you buck.
Oh.
Hop it.
You two skinheads.
What would you... Of course they're skinheads, eh?
Shut your mouth. Hop it. Of course we're skinheads. Do you want to feel my head?
Oh, can I?
Yeah, go on then, touch it. Touch my head.
Only prickly. Oh, Rebecca, feel his head.
No, don't feel it. Feel mine, Rebecca.
Hey, what's that mark? Can you hear it? That mark?
Shh, secret sign.
Rebecca? Rebecca?
Rebecca, you ain't touched my head yet.
Look, I really don't think you ought to be fraternising with the undesirable elements of society.
Rebecca?
Rebecca?
I know when you're getting the wrong idea.
Nah.
I mean, once I'm married, that's it. I'm Tony's wife. No more anky-panky on the side.
No, that's right.
Not unless I enjoy it.
Eh? Now, what do you mean, not unless you enjoy it? Sharon? Sharon?
Brenda! Don't cry, Shirley!
Oh, leave me alone! I will die!
Shirley!
When I'm bad, I move with all the guys from my out of my class. I can't step in front, I think it's too much now. She's a violent man, she's coming out.
Sharon?
Come and get me.
Only once we've done this, that's it, right? Once and once only. Because when you're married, you'll be... What's the word?
Miserable. So come and get me.
I mean, you'll be Tony's wife. I don't want no repercussions.
I don't want no trouble.
Come and get me.
For Christ's sake, Sharon, leave it out. The undressing was half the fun. Sharon?
So come on, then. Strip off.
You ain't supposed to be like this. Blunt and that. You're supposed to be... what's the word? Warm and tender.
I don't want warmth. I want sex.
Look at that. Across the street. There's
a car built just... Last year this was, about 15, 24 tents coming at a cab looking for it.
What?
Trouble.
Did you?
Oblige.
Oh,
lovely, isn't it?
Yeah, fantastic.
Want one?
Oh, no thanks, Bobby, no. Thing is, Bobby, fighting's basically wrong.
Oh, yeah, of course it is. But it ain't all fun. No, the thing is, Rebecca, no one's ever tried to reform me. No one's ever taken the time to help.
Well, I'm here to help. On or off duty, a policewoman's always there to help.
Well, come on then. Help me.
Hello, Johnny.
Hello, Vicky.
Do you mind?
No.
Nor do I.
Hello, Brenda.
Look.
Johnny, that tip you give me, it failed. The tip didn't fail, you did.
No!
Where are you going?
Where are you going? On or off duty, a police officer can do as she pleases. He pleases me.
You don't mean that. You don't really mean that.
Well, I can't think of anyone else more attractive.
You know what I am?
Stupid.
Extremely drunk.
Hello, darling.
You talking to me?
Glad I to get, eh? My name's Phil. What's yours?
Stanley.
Stanley? Nice name. Very feminine. Very pretty, if I may say so, Stanley.
Is he bothering you, Stanley? Are you bothering her?
What's she gonna do with you, you drunken sod?
Say that! Say that! You want some food, you got it!
Hold up, it ain't supposed to be like this. I'm the man. If there's any seducing to be done, I'm gonna do it.
Shut your mouth and kiss me.
For Christ's sake, Sharon. Johnny's a mate of mine. I didn't want any of this. I mean, he wouldn't do it to you, would he? Eh?
It's you that got me up here. Now do something about it.
All I wanted was a little bit of friendly hanky-panky. That's all I wanted.
You've got a lifetime of hanky-panky. I ain't got no time at all. If you're gonna do the business, Larry, just do it.
Hold up!
I need a tip.
I've got a good one for you. Sam Diggins.
Yeah.
Lucky sod.
Hey?
Rebecca Perry wants you in the bedroom.
Rebecca Perry? Well, I didn't think she liked me.
Oh, I don't know nothing about that. I'm only the messenger boy.
You sure?
You don't want it then? Fair enough. If you can't handle it, I'll go.
No, no, I mean... Rebecca Perry.
Business first.
Right.
Well, I have been out in the cold.
See my head? My hair? The way it's combed?
Yeah.
I have to comb it like that to disguise the 130 stitches I had put in after the Brixton trouble. See, Rebecca, the thing is...
Look, Bobby, the reason I brought you up here...
Look, I know why you brought me up here.
The first job of a police officer, Bobby, the first job of a police officer...
Oi, shut your noise!
I'm trying to do my job! I want to explain to you the rights and the wrongs. The do's and the don'ts.
Look, I don't care what you want to talk about, just as long as you do.
Do? What?
Do it with me up here.
No,
don't. Of course you do. Anyway, if you don't, I'll make you.
Mistletoe.
Yeah?
You dangle it above her head. As it dangles, you kiss her. Hard, hot. Quick.
Yeah, but I want more than just one festive kiss.
Well, things will develop from that. And as you're a good friend, 30 pence.
How much?
Well, it don't grow on trees, does it?
Bobby!
Anyone seen Rebecca Perry?
She's in here.
Push off, Diggins.
I was told you wanted to see me.
Push off, Diggins.
Told?
Johnny Reeves, down by the toilet.
Johnny Reeves, down by the toilet?
Told me you wanted me.
I know what he told you, and he's got no right telling you nothing. I'm trying to do my job.
Who was she?
Hey, Reeves!
She was with me. Yeah? She ain't anymore then, is she?
I told you before, and I'll tell you again, push off, Diggins!
You've got no right telling people I want them when I don't!
What?
Oh, I see. Homosexuality.
Huh? Just do what I told you, and good luck.
See this Johnny Reeves? He likes fellas.
Might do.
He's a bloody puff.
Maybe. Maybe not. I'd like to see you with your uniform on. And then I'd like to see you with your uniform off. Know what I mean?
If you don't watch it, I'll see you in court. On or off duty, it's an offence to attack a police officer.
I'm not attacking you. I'm pulling you.
Oh, no. I'm pulling you.
Very nice. You should be proud of your body. Very good for public relations.
What's she doing?
Killing herself.
You want to hang?
Manage.
I don't want to be above the law. I just want to get on top of the law.
Hey! Hey, Larry. It's me, Tony.
Hello, Tom.
Have you seen Sharon?
Last time I see her, she was down in the kitchen.
You sure about that?
Yeah.
Great. Come on, Sonia, the old nag's not up here. I'm sorry about this, Larry, but I've got to be a bit clever, you know. I don't want to jeopardise me marriage, me meals, you know what I mean?
Oh.
Who've you got, then? Shanty a swap? Well, Sonia, don't mind. Dear Sonia. Well, you've got to get through as many as you can before the big day, haven't you? Hello, love. What's your name, then? Eh? Silent type, eh?
Well, to tell you the truth, I don't care what your name is.
Just as long as you do the business. That's the way to do it, isn't it, Larry? Eh? Larry? Oh, come on.
Bloody hell, do you think you're doing, girl?
Hey!
Don't give me that! Don't give me the innocent!
I ain't innocent!
I know you ain't innocent! You're up here with him, naked!
I wasn't with him, I was with you!
Exactly. You was with me, we was engaged, and we was gonna get married!
What do you mean, was?
Well, you don't honestly think I'd marry a two-timing old slag like you, do you?
Brenda don't want to know you drunken sod.
Thanks, Sam.
It's all right.
Aye.
Thought you was in need of some protection. Dumps?
Lovely. See you.
head, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Could you write it for me?
What do you think this is, Balance?
Please. The last request.
All right, come on in. It's about time the police were exposed for what they really are.
To whom it may concern, I, Shirley Gordon, being a sound mind and fat body, have decided after much thought and no sex to do away with myself. Sorry, Dad, and to you, Mum, and to you, Auntie F. I would also like to say sorry to my brother and his friend Wayne, little Stevie, and all the girls at work, Mr. Rogers, and Lionel the Greek down the Wimpo. Thanks. And goodbye.
Has anybody ever told you how pretty you are?
No.
Don't surprise me. Good fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
Slag. What'd you call her?
Slag.
Shut up, Toby.
Yeah, shut up, Toby.
Well, she ain't no slag.
If I say she's a slag, she's a slag.
You come here uninvited, just like a tramp, calling people slags, knocking drugs about.
Getting stroppy.
I don't mind none of your lip.
Just don't give none of it to her. She's a friend, and I like her.
Oh, yeah? Well, she don't like you. Don't like him, do you, Brenda?
Yes, I do.
But he's a prat.
He's a friend. Now leave him alone, can't you?
That's all right, girl. I can look after myself.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Let him try.
Since you're about to go, and I'll probably be the last person you ever speak to, I'd just like to say, in all honesty,
what?
After a few more pints, I could quite fancy you.
Really?
Yeah, well, 4 or 5. No, 6 or 7. You'd be laughing. Don't tell no one.
Do you know what it's like? Have your nose broken?
Yeah.
Oh. Do you know what it's like? Have your nose cut off?
No. What's up?
I was just about to misbehave myself.
Oh, Johnny! Oh, is that all? What's he done?
Got lippy.
Shouldn't have done that, Toby. Very silly thing to do.
Oh, I realise that now.
Help him then.
Who?
Toby!
Golly! Look, I'd like to help you, Toby, really I would. But you have got to learn your lesson.
You bastard! Sort him out, Sam.
Who?
Robbie! You're the law, Sam, you can do it.
Better not, eh, Sam?
No, I better not. Besides, who really cares?
I do! Right,
everyone else! I think Bobby's going to need some space, aren't you, Bobby?
Gary, please! I'm going to take you apart. Do you smell horses?
All right, hold up, Bobby! Out!
We should do something!
Gary! No, Bobby, no! No, hold up, look! Look, instead of a knuckle, you and me arm wrestle.
Are you drunk?
If you win, you can keep my car.
You are drunk.
There's the keys.
Yeah, what if you win?
If I win, will you leave?
Fair enough.
Yes?
Yeah? Yeah. I thought you was right-handed.
Yeah, but when I arm wrestle, I always grip with me left. Then I leave with me right.
I don't even want to think about it.
We better not get involved. Besides, we're off duty.
Seen Johnny. Don't care if I never see him again in my life.
Bastard. Thank you.
Sod.
Right, let's get Toby to the hospital.
Least you could do.
Let him walk.
Shut your mouth.
You finished yet, Bobby?
How'd you do that, Toby?
Surprise.
You ain't a Burke after all.
No. Keys.
Hey?
Come on, son. Keys to the motor. Ain't got all night. Come on, girl.
Where are we going?
Kevin. You ain't taking her nowhere.
Hey?
You're nicked.
Grievous bodily harm.
Amongst other things. If I can do that to a big bloke like him, just you imagine what I could do to a little prat like you.
I said,
Yeah, well, I'll turn a blind eye to it this time.
Plonker.
Mind your backs. Studs coming through.
Disgust me, Frank. Do you know that? You disgust me. Every New Year's Eve the same. Paralytic drunk. Every New Year's Eve you embarrass me. Dancing about with a lampshade on your head. Making a spectacle of yourself.
Got a laugh?
No one laughed.
I laughed. Mrs. Dawkins laughed.
The least said about that bloody woman the better. Don't you think, Frank?
Yeah.
Don't you hear me? Your son is ill, Frank. The last thing he needs is a paralytic father bursting in on him.
Just like a million more out of the way. And why shouldn't you be reason why you're so happy? Part is over. They can't touch me now. starts like fascination. Ends up like a friend.
Then I got you a drink.
Oh, cheers, Larry.
Do us a favour, go out and get Toby out of the motor, eh?
Well, he won't want to miss seeing a new year in, will he, eh?
Do me a favour.
Go and get him yourself.
I've got me hands full.
Oh, thanks a lot, mate.
Everyone, I never told my mum and dad about the party. I made out I was ill.
Hey, it's nearly 12.
Shut your mouth. The thing is, you've come home early. Look, turn off all the lights, no one speak, and with any luck, they'll go straight to bed.
Everybody's at it.
Everybody's disgusting.
Give her one for me.
Then don't. The house is worth 50,000. Come on.
Where are we going?
Bed, Frank, bed.
Bed?
To sleep. Frank.
On the sofa like we used to.
I don't know.
Of course you know.
Don't turn the light on.
It's dark.
Spoil the mood.
You mustn't wake Larry.
We won't. Quite a long old time, isn't it? You and me on the sofa. Happy New Year, go. What happened to the party?
All gone home?
Nah, ain't 12 yet.
I really like you, Toby.
I know. And you ain't so bad yourself.
Bet you say that to all the girls.
Yeah, I do. Well, that's all very strange.
Hey?
Bit quiet, isn't it?
Yeah. But it's nice. Romantic.
Yeah.
Oi! Larry! And don't come in, son!
Larry?
Oh, shit.
Hey?
Well, this is a surprise, isn't it?
Yes, I suppose it is.
It's a party.
Surprise party.
Yeah, surprise party.
Surprise!
I'm glad you could make it in time.
Well, it is in your honour.
Is it?
Yeah! Yeah! Surprise party in your honour.
You certainly surprised us, all right.
Yeah, well, I hope you ain't going to get angry about it, after all the hard work we put in arranging it for you.
Terry, Mrs. Ascot.
Nice.
He's, wet.
Larry got you a present, Mrs. Ascot.
Did he? Did I?
Oh, yeah.
What is it?
It's a aftershave.
Wild stallion aftershave.
Yeah, but it's unisex aftershave.
Try it.
Oh, smells of horses.
You know it? Yes, it... Well, why didn't someone tell me?
We did, you brat!
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
At midday we'll